Hi everyone, I'm Gus Posey. I'm the steam lead here at Wings Over the Rockies Air and Space Museum. Today I'm going to show you a little bit of a unique paper airplane, something you might not have seen before, something a little bit more creative, but also something that uses an interesting aerodynamic principle that I hope you're thinking about. Once again, we're going to need just a basic piece of paper here. You can use an 8.5 by 11 sheet or an A4 piece of paper if you're in a different part of the world, but just a nice rectangular piece of paper and possibly a tool for flattening. I like to use a marker, but whatever you have handy that can give you a nice, clean, crisp edge. Now in this example, I'm going to start with the paper in a little bit of a different shape. I'm going to put the long edge down here towards me with the short edge of the paper onto the side. Now whenever you're ready to begin, I'm just going to grab the corner down here at the very bottom, and I'm going to grab that corner and fold it up and over, going past the edge, and kind of scooting until right here I have a 90 degree angle. This size is the same size as this, and this is the same size as this. So we're talking about parallel lines here and a nice right angle right here in this corner. And once again, I'll get this nice and flat. And hopefully we can see that that's pretty close right here as a nice right angle. Now, once you've got this shape right here, you've already got most of your plane built, believe it or not, but we're gonna do a couple more things just to make sure it flies. And then we'll start to talk about that interesting aerodynamic principle. Down here at the bottom edge of the page, I'm going to grab this and fold it twice. Now it's important that you notice that when I'm done folding the second time, I'm past the edges of the wing by about an inch. Let me show you what I mean. On the first fold, I'm just folding upwards about half an inch, maybe a couple centimeters, going nice and smooth all the way across. Again, maybe using my tool just to make sure I've got a nice crease there. But as you can see, I haven't made it past the edge here, and I haven't made it past the edge here. So I need to fold it twice to make sure that happens. On the second fold, I might go a little bit higher just to make sure that when I'm done folding, I've got a tab over here and I've got a tab over here. Now, once you have a shape like this, you're ready for the super crazy part. So be ready for this, and hopefully you've got a table kind of like mine. I'm gonna grab this by the tabs, and if you can see this, I'm just holding the tabs here and here firmly and turning them face down. Right on the corner of the table, this tab goes straight down, this one goes straight across. Straight down, straight across. And you can imagine you can do this quite a few times, but you're just looking for this. It's a little bit curved, it's very flat, and a little bit bumpy. It has these little marks across it, these crenellations, but those are gonna help it fly too. A nice flat surface with these little bumpy areas are gonna help this work as a wing. Now, if you've seen a wing like this, you might have seen some wings with winglets, those positions on the wings where the vertical surfaces tilt up a little bit. Airlines use those on planes like the 787 to reduce drag, save gas, save money, etc. We can do that today as well. We can raise these up and up and up, and in fact, I'm going to raise them all the way to the point where this one slides right inside of here, just like this. This is called an annular wing, also called a ring wing. But as you can see, it's just a round shape, and the wing section goes all the way around, so the drag reduction comes all the way down to essentially zero back here at the trailing edge of the wing. Now this one's a little bit easy to fold, hopefully you saw that, and a little bit tricky to launch. I'll give you some specific tips on how to get that flying here in just a minute. All right, now that you've folded your ring wing, you're gonna need a little bit of space to test it. Pretty easy to fold, but a little bit tricky to launch. I recommend this method, but you're welcome to try anything that works. Take two fingers, put them inside the ring on the triangles, just like this. So your thumb is on the outside. And then if I want to fly this direction, I'm going to stick my arm the opposite direction, keeping it straight at the shoulder, the elbow, and the wrist. And then I'm just going to bring it to my head. When I get to my head, I'm just going to let go. Thanks for watching, everyone. Join me next time for more tutorials.
Thanks very much for watching. You know, we've got a lot of really great artifacts in this museum, and we can hardly wait until the time comes when we can open our doors again and you can come and see them in person. Until that time, we're going to be working very hard to bring you new content, new demonstrations, new workshops, all kinds of wonderful things for you to watch on video. We're really dedicated to our mission of educating and inspiring people of all ages about the aerospace endeavors of the past, present, and future. If you like what you've been seeing, and if you want to support our museum, please follow the link below and make a donation. And thank you. Thank you very much.